The future of autonomous public transportation in cities is a promising area of innovation that has the potential to greatly improve the efficiency and accessibility of public transportation systems. Autonomous buses and shuttles can be programmed to optimize routes and schedules, reducing wait times and increasing the frequency of service. It also can be operated at a lower cost than traditional systems and can make public transportation more accessible to people with disabilities or limited mobility. As these technologies continue to evolve, we can expect to see more cities implementing autonomous public transportation systems and integrating them with existing transportation networks to create a more seamless and efficient transportation experience. One of them is the second largest city in Switzerland, Geneva, which is looking toward a time when transportation is autonomous. There are several benefits to using autonomous public transportation services to travel the route of your choice whenever you want, without drivers or other staff on board. But their widespread deployment still faces major obstacles. Join us today as we will take a look at Geneva's plans for driverless public transportation. Three European cities, including Geneva, will test an autonomous and on-demand public transportation service as part of the European Consortium Ultimo. The University of Geneva is actively participating in a new European partnership that is building on the work of the H2020 Avenue Consortium, which operated from 2018 to 2022. Geneva is one of the three experimental cities in Europe where the Horizon Europe Ultimo project will develop an automated minibus service. A total of 55 million euros will be allocated to the initiative over 4 years, with 16 million coming from the Swiss Confederation and 24 million from the European Commission. The purpose of Avenue was to investigate both the technological and financial viability of an automated on-demand transportation service as well as any potential psychological barriers to its utilization. According to Dimitri Constantis, full professor and director of the Information Science Institute of the Geneva School of Economics at the UNIG, associate coordinator and technical director of Ultimo, the project's aim is to create a real business model that addresses the specific economic, legal, and security concerns of such a service. This European consortium includes 23 participants from 8 different European nations. The University of Geneva, Geneva Public Transport, the State of Geneva, the startup Mobile Thinking Sarl, the enterprises ArgUS and ZFCVSA, and the associations Open Geneva and SOM are among the 8 Swiss partners who are involved. The consortium will deploy its activities in 2 test cities in addition to Geneva, Kroneck in Germany and Oslo in Norway. It will be led by Deutsche Bahn AG and will have a budget of 55 million euros over 4 years, of which 24 million will come from the European Commission and 16 million from the Swiss Confederation. There will be 45 vehicles deployed in all. Before we continue, if you would like to learn more about future infrastructure and construction megaprojects around the world, make sure to subscribe to this channel for more interesting videos. An autonomous electric bus service operating around the clock in Geneva, Switzerland, will be introduced starting in 2025, according to local media on Thursday, December 2022. As part of the Horizon Europe Ultimo Mobility Initiative, Geneva has been selected as one of 3 European test sites for a full-scale driverless public bus service, according to Swissinfo.com, a website run by the Swiss Broadcasting Corporation. The report lists Oslo and Kroneck as the additional test locations. There will be a total of 45 vehicles used, 15 of which will be in Geneva. Ultimo will concentrate on problems like how to protect the safety of passengers and respond, for example in the event of accidents or incivilities, in the driverless unmanned shuttles. The Swissinfo.com report stated that it would also examine price issues, minimum and maximum bus destination distances, and the regulatory environment. The service would be of higher quality if it offered door-to-door, on-demand, 24-hour transport. Additionally, by preventing empty journeys during off-peak hours, some expenditures would be cut. Finally, congestion and lineups at stations might be prevented via real-time demand response, it was claimed. Ultimo will focus on addressing issues that are very specific, such as how to secure the security of passengers, and will provide answers to issues like what ticket rates should be set when the routes are in high demand, for the destinations served, what minimum and maximum distances should be set, how can the current legal system, which prohibits autonomous buses from exceeding 30 km per hour, be modified, not to mention the difficulties in standardizing the territory's modeling in order to make it compatible with the guidance systems of the greatest number of vehicles and save technical expenditures. The objective of Ultimo will be to create a practical business model that deals with the specific economic, legal, and security concerns associated with an automated on-demand transport service. Identifying the minimum and maximum distances is the primary goal of the project's first section, which also addresses issues with passenger safety and ticket pricing. A total of 55 million euros will be spent on the project over 4 years, with 16 million euros coming from the Swiss Confederation and 24 million euros from the European Commission. The deployment of the autonomous transportation service in the field will take place during the second phase of the project, which runs from 2025 to 2026. A variety of shuttles will be deployed in Geneva to evaluate the system's compatibility. Since the beginning, the TPG has been a partner and has stated its goal. Denis Berdoz, the TPG's Director General, explains that we are thinking about the public transport of the future in addition to managing mobility in the Geneva conurbation on a day-to-day basis. We are confident that over time, driverless vehicles will play a bigger part in traffic. With the help of this big endeavor, we should be able to gain the knowledge necessary to comprehend the future. Serge Dal Busco, State Councilor of the Republic and Canton of Geneva in charge of the Department of Infrastructure, notes that it is an opportunity for the Canton of Geneva and the TPG to participate in this avant-garde international project, which can usefully renew and broaden the public transportation offer in the context of the profound changes that our mobility will undergo in the coming years. The widespread introduction of autonomous public transport would have many advantages. By offering door-to-door, on-demand, 24-hour transport, the service would be of higher quality. It would also avoid empty trips during off-peak hours and thus reduce some costs. Finally, by responding to demand in real time, queuing and congestion around stations could be avoided. This is a real paradigm shift in public transport, concludes Dimitri Constantis. Therefore, keep in mind that you'll encounter the autonomous public transportation vision the next time you make a trip to the city of Geneva. Do you believe the notion of autonomous public transportation is brilliant? Leave your comments in the space provided below. Also, like, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell to get notified whenever we upload a new video. Bye for now, and thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.